Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today I have a cute little pen from Camlin. This pen is called Camlin 47, and this model is one of the oldest model from Camlin, and it is still available in the market. They still produce this pen. However, this pen is not readily available. You need to find this pen. It is available with some online stores, but I don't know, it is not available readily in the regular stationery shops. So I'll cover the parts of the pen and then what I like and what I dislike in this pen. Right, starting with the cap. The cap is aluminium and the clip is also aluminium, I think. The clip is a little tight and they have their signature Kokuyo Camlin on the clip and Camlin 47 engraved on the neck of the cap. So this pen has a semi-hooded nib, right, and it has an ebonite feed. It's a piston filler, so it takes more ink than the cartridges and the converters. It's a thin pen, it is not very fat, so it takes more ink than regular cartridges and converters, but not that much large ink. So this pen has a very good balance. It is not a very big pen. It's a small pen. It can be posted and posted securely. And after posting, the balance even becomes very, you know, good, because this cap is not very heavy. So it makes the back of the pen a little bit heavier and easy to use. But I like to use it without the cap because I have small hands. So if you have big hands, then you can post this pen also. So it has an ink window to let you know, and it lets you know how much ink is available and how much is not, if it is fulfilled or not. Then this pen can, the nib unit of this pen can be completely disassembled for easy cleaning. The things that I don't like in this pen is, you know, it takes a lot of scratches. Like here you can see, when I post this pen here, I get a lot of scratches here. The other thing is, this pen gets dry. So I'm using this pen from past few weeks now regularly. I had this pen from past few years, but I haven't used it that much. So I'm using this pen regularly from past few weeks, and if I leave this pen in without using, in just with ink for 2 to 3 days, it tends to dry out, and then you have to prime the nib again, and then, you know, it works again. It works well. But for this price range, this is a very cheap pen. It costs around, you know, 70 to 100 rupees. You will find it anywhere between that. You get a pen that is a piston filler. You can see here the piston moving. So a piston filler, ebonite feed. These are the features of a very good pen. So if you look out for these features in the market, you will get very expensive pens that have both ebonite feeds and then, you know, a piston filler. So the other thing that I, you know, not dislike in this pen, but generally this pen only comes in fine nib. So I like medium or broad nibs. So this comes only in fine, but this nib writes okay. This is not a very scratchy nib. We'll see in this sample. So otherwise, this is a very nice pen to have, you know, a piston filler, a great looking pen. And size wise also, it is not very, very small, but it is a small pen. I'll compare it with, this is Parker Frontier, and this is Lamy Safari. You can see it is almost the size of Frontier, right? Even if we uncap it, it is almost the size of Parker Frontier. So if you are comfortable with Parker Frontier, you should be comfortable with this pen also. It is a little smaller than Lamy. Yeah, but for that price range, I think this is a very, very good deal and very good pen to have. So let's have a small writing sample. So we have, so there is a skip right away. 47, kind of a vintage pen. Ink is Brill Black. Okay, so this nib is not very smooth. It's a fine nib, so it gives some feedback, but it is not that scratchy. It's a steel nib, so it's a hard nib and does not have much line variation. If you push it hard, it can give some line variation, but it does not. So we should not push it too hard because this is a steel nib. Then about, it's a quite wet writer. It's okay, not very wet, but it's medium. Since it is a fine nib, so it is expected to be a little bit on the drier side, but it is not that dry. It's okay. So overall, this pen is a must-have pen if you are a collector. You need to have this pen in your collection. This is a vintage pen nowadays. And if you are a regular writer, you can use this pen. It has immense ink capacity, and you can write about, when fully filled, you can write about 8 to 10 pages directly with this pen, and the ink does not goes out. And when the ink is about to go out, then you can see it on the ink window. Hope this helps, and thanks for watching the video. Please like the video, share the video, and most importantly, do subscribe to the channel for more updates and exciting videos. Thank you. Bye-bye.